excited are you for it?
Very excited. You know, it's something you work toward your whole life. You know, as a kid, very fortunate to be in this position. You know, like I said earlier, it sucks that Derek got hurt. You know, our leader of our team, one of the best dudes in the building. But, you know, have a job to do. Got to go out there and execute at a high level.
How'd you react to the news?
It was exciting. You know, found out Tuesday morning. It was exciting. You know, they have confidence in me. But, you know, I love our group. You know, we got so many talented dudes that I can lean on and don't have to do too much and just facilitate the ball to them.
What was the message from DA to you about starting?
Yeah, you know, I spoke to Clint about it. You know, Clint said, hey, let's have a great week. Let's prepare at a high level, put a great plan together. And, you know, it was brief and short, and we got to work. So that was good.
Spencer, Dennis said you have always had a no-flinch mentality. I know a lot of people have described that in you. Is that something you picked up along the way, or you've had that since middle school?
Yeah, I feel like that's something, you know, I've had since I was a kid. You know, I think just playing multiple sports coming up, always being a super competitive in whatever I did, you know, going to middle school in PE, playing dodgeball, kickball. I mean, just being ultra competitive and then, you know, being able to go through success and adversity at the college level. You know, I think that develops that no flinch mentality, I guess you could say. But, you know, you got to be fearless as a quarterback, and I think that's the number one key you got to have.
Were you cooking kids in dodgeball? Always been able to throw like that?
Yeah, man. Yeah. You know I was.
So, yeah, you started as a freshman in college, and then you go to, you know, started South Carolina. Obviously, I know, you know, picking up new things. First starts in different situations have always been pretty comfortable for you as far as?
You know, you're going to be anxious, a little definitely excited. You know, got to get those nerves out, but, you know, that's just the nature of the beast. You know, you got to go out there and play, you know, fall back on your preparation. You know, we've had a great week so far and got another, you know, 24, 48 hours to clean it up. So I'm excited for the opportunity to go out there with the guys.
How good a grasp do you have of this offense? Has there been any you know, shaving back for you, or do you feel like you have a pretty good grasp of everything?
Yeah, feel very confident about the plan. You know, something I love about Clint and our offensive staff is, you know, we tailor it to who's playing. So, you know, I like that a lot, feel confident about it, and we've had a great week so far.
How much do you feel like you've improved even in the week since we last saw you play a game?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a ton. I mean, I think I was talking to Nick the other day, you know, just about going against the ones every day on scout team. I know I'm not getting hit or this and that, but those are full-speed reps, and, you know, took total advantage of them because, you know, that's one of the best defenses in the league, and, you know, that's going to prepare you for whenever you have your shot.
Spencer, you mentioned playing on a high level, but playing in those high competitions on the collegiate level, how did it prepare you for this?
Great question. You know, I think, you know, obviously you got to take another step at this level. You know, it's going to be a lot harder. It's going to be a big challenge for us on Sunday. It's a great defense, great team, great coaches. So, football is football. You know, you got to go out there and trust in your training, trust in your playmakers, and go out there and just play, cut it loose.
Talk a little bit about the anxiousness in those other situations where you've had your first start in a new situation. What is it that sort of clicks in a game that makes you kind of settle in? Like,
yeah.
What's that moment for you usually?
I think just, you know, getting the ball out of your hand, getting a few completions early, you know, taking a hit or two, you know, get your juices flowing. I think, you know, that helps a lot. But, you know, as the game goes on, you get more calm, and you got to be cool, calm, and collected in the pocket as a quarterback, specifically, and the leader.
Has this week felt different for you? I mean, I know guys say all the time they're preparing as if they're playing, but the guys are looking at you now as a starting quarterback. I mean, you go into the week knowing you're the starting quarterback. Is there anything that changes for you?
Yeah, it's been different for sure. You know, a lot more on my plate, but it's been awesome. You know, taking full advantage of it, preparing at even a higher level. You know, really dialing in on all the little details. You know, that's been the big thing for me this week. You know, watching more tape, studying more film, and just being around the guys more, getting extra reps. And, you know, you get a ton more reps in practice. So I think that helps a lot with live reps and then, you know, getting your mental reps on the side as well.
Spencer Baker talked this week about, I guess you were on a cruise ship or something. You remember sitting on a row with
yep.
you and Lincoln and maybe Kyler too.
Yep.
But what do you kind of remember about that? And how special is that your first games against him?
You know, yeah, I think it's pretty cool. You know, I remember it was like it was yesterday. You know, me and my dad were sitting down, and yeah, Baker was pretty much recruiting me to come to Oklahoma. And so I was 18 years old at the time talking to him. You know, I've always been a fan of Bake, you know, respected Bake and how he worked and how he's overcame adversity himself. So respect the heck out of the guy, and you know, excited to be on the same field, not going against him, but going against his team. I think it's pretty special.
Any lessons he give you back then that you remember that just kind of stick?
You know, I wasn't at school with him, but I, you know, sat down with him, talked with him a few times. You know, I always respected him, though.
Spencer, obviously the Saints offensive line has got some backups in a lot of places, and pressure was an issue in this last game. Your experience with that situation last year, and how, I mean, how can that help you, like, knowing that sometimes you got to speed the clock up or whatever?
Yep. Yeah, you know, we're confident in those boys up front. You know, they grind harder than any of us in the facility every single day. We got a great protection plan, great pressure plan. You know, this defense is going to be throwing a lot at us. So you got to trust in them. I think that's the main thing. You got to trust in them. You got to trust that pocket. And when stuff does break down, because it will, you know, every O-line is going to break down here and there. But you got to be able to create, extend, and just find your playmakers.
I'm sure there have been a ton of people reaching out this week. Has Archie Manning reached out at all? Have you talked to him this week?
Yep, he reached out a few days ago. You know, just said he's rooting for me. He's been an awesome resource to have out here. You know, we'll text back and forth here a little bit, but he's awesome.
You said yesterday that your pocket feels kind of something that can't be taught. Is that just something that you've always had, or is that something you kind of developed over time? Like, where does that kind of come from?
Yeah, I think it just comes from playing the position since you were a kid. You know, obviously just being able to have that feel, you know. You can definitely coach a lot of it, but, you know, a lot of it's natural, but sometimes you just got to create that extra millisecond to get that ball out. And, you know, I always felt like I can do that pretty good, and just want to continue to get better at that.
I don't know how much time you get with these guys usually, but how do you feel so far about your connection with guys like Chris Olave and Rashid Shaheed?
Feel good. You know, obviously got reps with them in training camp, which was good to have some familiarity with them, but no reps with them really this season so far. So this week has been big, you know, been targeting everybody a lot, trying to spread the ball around. So I think just trying to create that connection in a short week, you know, is a challenge, but it's a fun challenge.
Just have you been able to get a sense of how excited the fans are about this opportunity for you?
Yeah, you know, I just try to focus on what we got going on in here. You know what I mean? Try to keep my mind just thinking about the game, thinking about how we're going to do, how we're going to execute. You know, obviously got a big challenge on Sunday, but, you know, I know it's going to be a great atmosphere. Happy we're at home, and, you know, obviously want to come out with a win.
Have you seen the memes and, like, the agenda and all that stuff?
I try not to pay attention to that. You know what I mean? Got a lot of other stuff we got to worry about in the building.
Looking forward to this moment since you're a kid. There's, like, a lot of people who kind of get you to this point.
Yeah.
So what was, like, the reaction of family, friends, your quarterback coach you've worked with forever when you told them you were in the starting?
Yeah, man, it was special. You know, a lot of people reaching out, a lot of former coaches, obviously, you know, mom, pops, sister, you know, girlfriend, everybody. You know, very excited. You know, something we've been working for, toward a long time. So I want to go out there and play well and help my team win, and it's going to be fun.
Are you going to be there for the game on Sunday?
Yeah. Yep.
Was there anyone that you heard from that you, like, you didn't expect that you're like, well, this person's in camp?
I can't think off the top of my head. I got a ton of texts on my phone. I got to get back to
them. Did you take anything from, like, the rest of this rookie class quarterbacks who played pretty well so far? Maybe
there's a few guys that have played pretty well. You know, I enjoy to watch as much as I can, you know, just to see how they perform, you know, under certain circumstances and see what they do. So, yeah, I mean, there's definitely a few guys that have played well, and, you know, I obviously want to be one of those guys as well. So that's the plan.
Tampa has gone against a few rookie quarterbacks. Is there anything you take from that, specifically how they may try and attack you?
Yeah, I watched, you know, Bo play them, Jaden play them, you know, two guys I'm very familiar with, came up with. I thought they both did a good job against them, you know, on tape. Obviously, they threw a lot at both of them, both rookie quarterbacks. I expect the same. So just got to be ready, got to be prepared, and we will.
How excited are you about the potential downfield dynamic with Rashid Shaheed and all he's done so far this season?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been exciting to watch him, man. Special talent, him, Olave. I mean, you know, Tipton can get down the field. We got a lot of guys that can run, as you know. So, you know, if they're there, I got to trust them, put it out in front of them, and let them just go get it.
What's Derek kind of talk to you about this week? Derek,
yeah, man, he's been great. I mean, he said, hey, look, anything you need, I'm here. And that's the, you know, most solid dude I've been around. You know what I mean? Just people person, great character. You know, that speaks volumes of who he is. So, I mean, just giving you a little information about what to expect, you know, be nice and calm, cool, and just go cut it loose. You know, Derek's been awesome. couldn't ask for a better leader in that room.